Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about how can we communicate our needs. I'm Rita and today it's all about you. Communicate our needs involves always two situations. The first, the recognition of our own needs by ourselves. So you must know and understand which your needs are. And of course, this requires that you spend a little bit of time with yourself. Listen to your body needs, listen to your mind. Start to enroll in moments that you can feel relaxed in order for you to listen better what your body is trying to tell you. Analyze every time that you are enrolled in situations where you are not feeling comfortable. And try to pinpoint in this time that specific need. The second situation or phase or step is when you start to communicate these needs that you know already that you have to other people. And the first tip for you to do it is to be kind and empathic to others. So if you don't like a certain person's behavior or acts, try to point that to themselves, but in a calm, relaxed and constructive way. Explain to the other person why this behavior is triggering you and be open about the reason behind and your feelings toward that behavior. Explain how a behavior can be okay for you, so explain how to change the behavior and try to make the other person understand what is a behavior that is okay for you, that doesn't trigger you any type of negative feelings. Tell the other person exactly what you want. Not focus exactly in what you don't want, but in what you want, what you expect, and what you would like to happen, or what kind of behaviors the other person could have for you to feel better about that situation in particular. Lower your expectations to protect you from frustration, and valorize any kind of effort that the other person is starting to do to attend your own needs. Remember that this can be a case of setting boundaries, for instance, or communicate your feelings to a toxic person, or just tell to the other person when you are uncomfortable, particularly with some behaviors or with some situations. Communicate in an honest way, respectful and polite. Use gratitude and share appreciation with yourself and with the other person involved. Any types of relationship, people need to know how to tell what they want and what they need. Particularly if this is a familiar or close friend or intimate relationship, people have to use an open communication to tell others how can they help them, to rule expectations, because if not, that relationship can tear apart easily. And I will give you some practical examples of the situations that can eventually make you feel uncomfortable, for instance with a family member or with a close friend. Maybe you need to set some boundaries because this person is kind of invading your private space and your private life, and this is something that of course, it has to be said in a very cautious way, in a very polite and honest way, but also in a very firm way, in order for the other person understand exactly what you are talking. In an intimate relationship, particularly in the beginning of an intimate relationship, it is very important that you can communicate your needs, because after the first phase of seeing everything great and blue and brilliant, you will start to the second phase, which is adapt to each other. And sometimes you need to just make some adjustments. And these adjustments may be you telling what type of needs you want or need. And this is important for you to know how to do it without really end the relationship, or just without you cause any type of hurt or pain in the other person. So it is important that you communicating your needs can really open honest communication in your relationship for the future and for the sake of that relationship. And of course this has a specific cause, which is taking care of yourself and taking care of your own needs is the main thing in any type of relationship. No relationship can survive if both people that are into it are not taking care about themselves first. And if we think straight, all individuals are having basical needs to fulfill. And for this we talk about the need of attachment, which plays a role of the first relationship of a person, which is with the family members. And of course this attachment in this phase, it is crucial to be with the mother or the first caregiver. And this helps this child turning into a confident adult, and also teach the main things about relationships and about connections with others. The other basic need that we need is the need of control, particularly over our mind and over the uncontrollable situations that we can live through life. And for that we need to build our own orientation for our own self-control in order to be able to adapt ourselves to new situations, and particularly to be more resilient in the things that we cannot control in our life. We need the confidence and self-esteem to reach goals and purpose, and we need the pleasure in the things that we are doing and in the situation and experiences that we'll have during our lifetime. Satisfying our own needs make us a satisfied person, which gives us an extra boost to reach our goals, dreams and purposes. Because we can't be fulfilled all the time, we need to use the rough phases to create our own personal growth and learning moment. When we keep ignoring our needs and our desires, we will increase the growth of mental health instability, psychological disorders, and turn to be much more susceptible to a mental health disorder or crisis. And so that's all for today, guys. I hope you like it. I hope you subscribe to the channel. Leave a thumbs up, share with a friend, comment if you want, and I'll see you next time for another video. Bye!